Hi everyone, my name is Sedat. I would like to welcome you to our webinar. Today I will introduce field extender that helps you to define any type of optional field to any Sage 300 transaction, attach documents and rich text, and print attached images on the crystal report. In field extender, you can do the following. You can add unlimited number of optional fields in different places in Sage 300. You can have it in any third-party SDK application. You can use electronic attachments and large formatted text fields. You can enter multiple records of optional fields, and Field Extender allows to have hyperlinks. Field Extender has a special lookup tool for optional field values. Now, let me go to Sage 300 and show how the program works. By using Field Extender, you can enter optional fields for any Sage 300 screen. First, you just need to configure that screen. We have done already for items screen, and whenever I will open this items screen, I will have a pop-up screen next to it, allowing to enter optional field values. For that purpose, I just need to select an item, and field values for the list of optional fields appeared here. One of these optional fields is allowing to touch file. Another one is allowing to make enter a rich text value. I have done already this type of entering for a few items. Let me show. If you touch a file which is a JPEG format or similar to this, you can see the image immediately next to that field. In case if you enter the rich text, you can open the rich text editor and see whatever has been entered here. I have done this for a few items. As you can see, the images are different for different items. And then you can use this entered optional field values in crystal reports. To do that, you need to modify existing crystal reports or make a new one. Let me show how it will work. I have done it in OYE invoices forms. Let me open the selection screen. From here, I just need to select that modified report file and print the report. If there is no optional field values entered for an item, then the layout will be the same, no difference. But in case if I have it already entered, then the optional fields will appear here. In this case, the item is shown here, and below to that image, the rich text information entered also is shown here. For different items, we have this very convenient. Field Extender allows to check the entered optional fields by using optional field inquiry screen. Let me open that screen. Here, you just need to select the transaction screen itself, which we are interested in. In our case, it was an item. Here, you need to make a selection. You can automate that selection and print the Go button, and the information will be populated on the screen, and you will see the optional field values entered for this particular transaction screen. The screen is named also as transaction in Field Extender. In order to use Field Extender, you need to configure it. This configuration can be done in Setup folder using these screens. It can be done manually or it can be done automatically. If you want to do it manually, then you need to use optional fields, field sets, and assign fields screens. Well, you can first define optional fields here, create at least one field set, and assign this field set using this screen. You can avoid this manual setup by using screen configuration, which will allow you to do everything in one go by making a default setup. For example, if I select one screen, and in order to configure it to use optional fields for that particular screen, by default it is inactive. You just need to make it as active. And if you want to make a default setup, you need to go here and make the default setup checkbox from no to yes and save it. And the screen will be available already for entering optional fields. Field extender has a separate screen for licensing. And from this screen, you can enter the activation code. You can apply and get an activation code for a particular screen or for all screens together. If here you select Field Extender Enterprise and enter the activation code, it will allow you to use all screen, any screen that you want to. Otherwise, if you have an activation code for a particular screen, you just need to change the license type here and select that particular transaction for which you want to enter optional fields. And if you have for it the serial number, just enter it from here. Field Extender has web screens, and you can do the same procedure to get optional fields from web screens. Let me show how it works. First of all, we need to log in to web screens. After logging in for a particular company, we will open a standard screen, but this standard screen will behave somehow differently. Instead of separate pop-up screen, which will be shown next to it, it will have a one button, new additional button. Let me open the item screen. Select an item. And by going down, we can see that here we have one additional button here, attachments button. And when I will click on it, only after that, the pop-up screen will be open for me, optional field values pop-up screen, allowing to enter optional field. For this particular item, I have already attached file. I can open it and I can enter the other optional field values if I want to. This is all.